Hello, welcome everyone to another talk at DebConf 22. This time we are listening to Debian / copyright improvement by Nobuhiro Iwamatsu and Kazuhiro Hayashi. They have a pre-recorded talk. They are remote, joining us from Japan, and they will be available for questions and answers after the pre-recording plays.
Hello. Thank you for joining this talk. I'm Kazuhiro, working for Toshiba, and my colleague Nobuhiro will make a talk about Debian copyright improvement. So Debian copyright file, as you know, is one of the very important files in Debian packaging. The file is intended to describe the copyright and license for both upstream and packaging part. And there is one standard format, initially drafted as DEP5. It is very helpful to understand which file has each license or copyright information, or also helpful to pass this kind of information by script, for example. And now it is use of this specification is optional and not mandatory as a part of Debian policy. And apart from that, there are many tools exist for the reviewing this file or creating some new template of Debian copyright file. These kind of tools have different IAMs and based on different scanners, for example. And it seems that the one of the most famous tools is a license check that is used by the many review tools. And now we would like to define some issues about the Debian copyright files. One of the issue is in some cases the contents of these files that do not match the actual information in the source package. For example, some license information are detected or detected and identified, but a bit different from the real information. And also, sometimes the information becomes very old and not up to date. And another point is we are thinking that some more active checks are required to detect the changes in this file when the package is updated. So now this kind of check up to each maintainer and few common methods to notice these changes. So here are motivation to improve contents of the Debian copyright file by sharing some result of existing activities and also by providing the new tools to detect the changes in the package update. So I'd like to introduce several approaches here. First one is about manual improvement with pathology. And second one, the first one is mainly from the user's perspective for using the Debian packages. And the second one is about checkers implemented in each package. The last one is some suggestions about shared service to detect the changes in Debian copyright. Let's check the details one by one. So about the first approach, manual improvement with pathologies. The background is we are required to clarify licenses and copyright holders information when we use some Debian-based Linux environment to our products. This kind of clarification is required. And when we check the result of these activities, we found some differences between the existing Debian copyright file at our result. So we are thinking that there are some contributions will be necessary for us to suggest improvement by telling this kind of facts we found in our activities. And also, it's important to synchronize our activities with the Debian package maintenance to avoid some distributing about copyrighting, collecting, and defining Debian copyright information. So the goals of this approach is to suggest improvements for the Debian copyright to package maintenance. This is not a one-off work, and it should be the continuous work, because package will be updated continuously. And another goal is to understand more effective ways to suggest the improvement for the Debian copyright. This means to solve some differences in concept and policies of license check process between the different environment. So here's a very basic workflow of the, these activities. So first, the source package will be imported and automatically scanned in using the posologies. The scanners is available in the posology, and it automatically detects the license and copyright folders information and generate the data. So after that, user do some manual review about this data and conclude, identify the license and copyright information, then generate the concluded data here. And this is a basic workflow for the product. But now we are thinking about some contributions to package maintenance. So the next step is to adjust the concrete data, comparing by adjusting Debian copyright files to solve some gaps between the two formats. So after that, we finally get some adjusted Debian copyright file, then create a patch and send it to the package maintenance. So another important topic is about in case of package updated, there are very useful functions in posologies that is called reuse functions. This can be used to reuse existing data of the older packages for the newer packages, then do the same steps, review and conclusion process, only for the detected differences. It can improved our manual report significantly. So the currently we have sent the several patches to the two Debian packages, and we will continue these activities for other packages also. And here are the lessons learned from these activities. It seems that this can detect more accurate licenses, but of course, the more and more manual efforts are required for review and comparison process. And we also find some pains in output format in the step three in the previous year. For example, the different license identifiers are used in the two files, and no wildcard is supported in the posology output. And also some match behavior about the copyright folders for the one files paragraph is different between the two Debian copyright files. Here is a bit detailed example about that. So left side, they are the original Debian copyright implemented in source package, and the right thing is the data generated through the posology and before a manual adjustment You can see some asterisk wildcard in the left side, but in right side, this format is not supported by default, and user need to modify, adjust it to the Debian copyright existing in the source package. And other things is about the red colored characters. There are three files, paragraphs here to show the different copyright information for each package, each file. But in this output, the all copyright information is automatically merged. This is one of the specifications of the DEP5 format by Fossologies. So this kind of things we need to solve in the compare and creating the patch. So the next step of this approach would be to continue with the improve for the Debian-based system. We are targeting on the first priority required packages. And also it would be make sense to make the five output of the Fossologies more practical to reduce the manual works in the comparison, as I explained in the previous slides. And to get more similar output to typical Debian copyright implementations, it is one of the, I think, activities to suggest some changes to the Fossology engines. Plans is to improve the workflow based on some feedbacks from the maintenance if we can get. So this is the second approach about package level checkers. The motivation would be to quickly and frequently validate the contents of Debian copyright in package updates by automating the change detections in that files. So goals, one of the goals is to implement check functions for each package. And the second one is to achieve the situation that the maintainers can detect changes in the copyright and license by just calling that functions. So here is one example of these activities. The file name is copyright check, implemented in the Ghost script and EM script and packages. So this script collect the output of multiple license check commands with appropriate parsing for this package. So now it's implemented as a package, very package specific, and try to parse the license check output to get the preferred format for the future analysis. And it's now implemented as a maintainer script and not as a build script. So user need to run expressly this script. And this script generates the output named copyright hints. It is automatically generated and intended to mechanically get the differences after the package updates. So as I already mentioned, it's now package specific. Each package may require its own parsing functions. And how to find the common functions seemed to be the key to expand this approach to widely to the all the other packages. Second example is a simpler one implemented in a Unilog package. It's defined an action to get the copy result. Then compare the result with the previous output. Now, this kind of implementation would be a good start to provide automatic detections for some packages. So I'd like to introduce some suggestions from us, shared service to detect the changes in Debian copyright. The motivation is to help the package maintenance to recheck the Debian copyright information when package updates by notifying the information or sharing some status monitoring. And also want to set up the place to share some know-hows about this kind of activities for detecting changes in Debian copyright. So one of the goals is to provide the back-end checker that can be used for any packages, Debian packages. And another thing is to run a web service to monitor the Debian copyright status in public space. It's very abstracted ideas for this approach. Now, I'll start by very simple prototyping, just compare the license check result between two package versions. Now we are talking about package A and two version base and latest. We provide backend functions to check the license and copyright information as a decopyright check. And by this one, generate, scan the license and copyright information and generate this kind of file, copyright old check for each version, base and latest. Then compare the result, then get the differences like this. You can see users can see some updated files or some files that include the new copyright information or the license easily, quickly. And this is here is a very simple image that we are try to provide as a web service. These kind of tables we would like to provide for the mainly package maintainers can easily understand what kind of changes are currently happening in the latest package version. So the future work, we would like to run the workflow continuously, then what we'd like to publish the status of each package with the different files. And also would like to consider to enhance some checker functions like the copyright check. So defining package specific settings, we are thinking would improve the different contents. For example, they exclude some files or patterns to focus on the worst information. And also try to take different scanners based on situation is one of the ideas. So here's other kind of approaches about scan code. It could be a replacement of some scan tools. And in this its database, there are many, many licenses defined, and it can detect many licenses and report it as a JSON format. And it also provides some GUI tools for the review. And it seems that the situation is it's concentrating on automate scan rather than the function for a manual review and conclusion like pathology. And another approach is, sorry, to make the copyright format as a part of Debian policy. This is very helpful if it provides common checks for the Debian copyright in printers, for example. But it's still a very challenging way we are understanding and difficulties of using this format in some package. So here's a summary. A direction of improving Debian copyright contents. One of these is to share updates contents by some reworks. And other things to create the tools to detect changes in package updates. So first approach I introduced is a manual reworks using pathology. It's planning to suggest more improvements for more packages and need to adjust rework result to typical copyright implementation. So the second one is a power package change detection. It automates the checks with package specific parsing. And we also introduced some activities to provide a shared checker service for any packages. And we are hoping that it may help package maintenance contributors to recheck Debian copyright file. And if possible, we'd like to optimize the checkers for each package. So that's it. Thank you for listening. If you have any questions, please let us know.
Do we have any questions from the audience? I can give you the mic. Otherwise, I have one. Do you think we need to change or at least create a specification of how to write Debian copyright? Because even if DEP 5 is more or less structured, you can still have huge diffs if you have one that was written by a person and one that was written by a machine, like the Fossology output or something. So do you think we need to, for example, mandate the order in which the blocks appear, like being alphabetically by file name, so that when the tool generates a new version, then it's easier to review the difference?
Yeah, so currently I have not concrete ideas about changing the existing format that is defined as version 1.0. But currently we are checking if there's some we can change the manual work site first. But after we can make some conclusion of this work, one idea would be to suggest some ideas for the Debian DEP 5 site as well. But this is still in work in progress. So in that case, we'd like to need more discussion with some responsible person who proposed DEP 5 format.
Cool. Anyone else? Yes, there wasn't there.
Yeah, thanks for your talk. Thanks for your talk. I don't know, maybe it's only for me, but this update of Debian copyright file is the most boring things in packaging at all, and it's more frustrating because if it's being rejected by FTP team, in most of cases it's Debian copyright. Thanks for your proposal. Would you think it's possible to automate the process of Debian copyright creating completely, just to exclude manual check, or it's completely not possible? I mean, parsing the whole source tree and finding some words about possible copyright mention. Thank you.
Thank you for your question. So, I'm not the Debian package maintainer yet. kind of feeling for me is it's still quite difficult to fully automate the generating or updating the Debian copyright information due to some complicated situation in the both license and copyright things included in each package. But we would like to evaluate this point through this kind of approaches, both from both manual works and anyway try to automate some change detection or generating the initial Debian copyright information. So we'd like to discuss and exchange opinions more in near future.
Okay, we have another question from IRC. DOD says he's the author of CME. Feel free to use CME for copyright update. That's why I wrote CME update the package copyright. Yeah, so I think CME is able to read the copyright file and update it in a way that minimizes the changes for the diff. So you might want to look into that.
Yeah.
Thanks. I heard how once tried to use ShinMui, actually, I think, if I understand correctly. At that time, maybe I had some, maybe I could not detect some changes that I intentionally add into the test package. So yeah, I would like to look at this one more time, but based on this kind of investigation, this time just suggest some ideas that based on license check. But of course, there are many kind of scanners or check to license or copyright check to in the listed in the Debian wiki page. So we still, yeah, there are some still need. There are some possibilities to based on the various tools for the license and copyright checking.
Okay, cool. We are out of time, but thank you very much for your presentation, for your answers, and for your work. It seems you guys like to tackle hard problems. So thank you very much.
Thank you too. Please enjoy your DebConf in person.
Thank you very much. Bye.